I know for us, like black girls, there is a lot of pressure to get a weave and it has to be graded A and things like that. So I'm looking at about 5,000 rand for hair alone. And obviously that puts a lot of pressure on my parents as well, because now they need to budget for 5k for a weave alone.
Obviously none of us girls want to have a duplicate, so we can't just buy a dress from a store. That will obviously have the risk of people having the same one.
Basically we help anybody that's looking for help. It was originally set up for the Hudson girls, but through word of mouth, every now and again we'll get another school that also comes. I help about 3 or 4 a year. We keep it very quiet. We don't like to advertise it. We don't like to show which girls we're helping it. It's all done in complete confidence. You come, we try to find a dress for you. If you find one, then off you go, and then the girls just bring it back when they're finished. And yeah, it's basically we're here to help whoever needs help. This is basically the original room that I used for the Fairy Godmother cupboard. Then it became far too small, so now we've moved lost property into here and made the bigger area, the area where we've actually got the Fairy Godmother.
Like, I think it's a very, very great initiative, because I think a lot of people in our school don't understand that there actually are people who can't afford it. Like, we have people in our school on, like, the feeding scheme and things like that, but people don't know about that. And, you know, for that person not to be able to afford, like, a dress or, like, a quality weave on the day, maybe that's the best that their parent could do for them. But then on the day, they're made to feel so bad for that. Or maybe because they can't even go because their parents can't afford to send them. Mm-hmm. And I think it's a nice way to kind of like cheer a person up and like make their day and stuff. Yeah. And to just give people hope, you know.